Celebrity surgeon Dr. Mehmet Oz has made not one, but two Fox News appearances in the 24 hours since jumping into the Republican primary, hoping to be Pennsylvania's next senator. He's praising former President Trump and criticizing President Biden's COVID mandates.
I think one of the greatest accomplishments of America is that we gave the world the mRNA vaccines through President Trump's Operation Warp Speed. I'm so happy that we were able to do that. And I got vaccinated, and I believe in vaccines. I don't believe in mandates. And I also don't believe it's the only path to success.
That Pennsylvania race, one of the big battlegrounds in the 2022 fight for control of the Senate. More than a dozen Republicans have said they're running. Oz is clearly hoping to win the Trump endorsement. It is up for grabs because the candidate who had Trump's backing bowed out amid a nasty custody battle that included abuse allegations. The panel is back to discuss. Number one, just that somebody actually was pro-vaccine on Fox is a good thing. So Dr. Oz should keep going on Fox if he will keep saying that. This is an interesting now. You have a celebrity candidate in a race that could well be one of the one or two or three we're looking at next November for which party controls the Senate.
Right, right. Also, first of all, Dr. Oz, not a great Jeopardy host, just to get that out there. But it's been really, and the Senate primaries in the Senate Republican primary races are going to be really interesting for the next midterm cycle. And it's almost like a houseification of the Senate Republican Conference, where you're seeing Republican candidates in these key races really dominated and really driven by their loyalty to the former president, who has such still a major grip on the party. And just to see, you know, for example, in Alabama, to go from a Richard Shelby to a Mo Brooks, or to a Roy Blunt to an Eric Greitens, a Pat Toomey to a cast of characters, which now includes Dr. Oz, it could have significant implications for governing, first of all, if Republicans do take control of the Senate as well. So there are a lot of dynamics here. It would be interesting to watch.
Yeah, and it also opens the question about whether any of those three key states that will control the control of the Senate, whether those Republicans can win. Missouri is a bit different, obviously, than Pennsylvania, which is a blue state. And so that was Mitch McConnell's big challenge back in 2010 and 2012, in that he had these Republicans elected or nominated who couldn't win statewide. Why? Dr. Oz is obviously different for a whole host of reasons. We'll see if he wins the nomination, but he is a celebrity, and that goes a very, very long way, as long as you can prove that you have even the most basic of policy chops.
Ideally he would actually live in Pennsylvania. He doesn't now. He lives in New Jersey. So in that way, he's certainly different from a lot of the other folks in the field. What will be interesting to see is his strategy clearly is to hug Donald Trump, right? We saw in Virginia the strategy there with that gubernatorial race and how it was sort of an arm's length when it came to Trump. He's clearly doing something different. Is that really going to be an effective strategy for him? We also saw from that race that these state races are about the state, are about sort of local issues that people care about. Yeah. He doesn't know anything about Pennsylvania. He doesn't live there. He has some ties there. I think he went to school there. His wife is from there. I think his in-laws live there. But I think that's going to be a real test for him. Can he actually convince people?
That'll be a test. You watch the other Republicans. The other Republicans will probably come at that, the carpetbagger idea. But number one, why do you want Trump to embrace you? Look at this. This is a compilation of polls averaged out. But the president's approval rating among Pennsylvania Republicans is off the charts, about 75%. Number two, you're right. It'll be about local issues. But will people press Dr. Oz? Number one, he's sold some quackery diets and the like online. He's tried to make his name off of that. But during COVID, you heard him just there talking about vaccinations. And again, that's a plus to have a Republican candidate saying vaccines are good. Amen. But early on in COVID, he said some things that people thought were really off, just not polite, not decent. And he corrected them. Listen.
I just saw a nice piece in The Lancet arguing that the opening of schools may only cost us 2 to 3% in terms of total mortality. And, you know, that's any life is a life lost. But to get every child back into a school where they're safely being educated, being fed, and making the most out of their lives with a theoretical risk in the backside, it might be a trade-off some folks would consider.
I've realized my comments on risks around opening schools have confused and upset people, which was never my intention. I misspoke.
Tried to clean that up because it just sounded crass.
Well, it did. It, absolutely. When you're talking about the lives of children. No. But it's not just that. There are other, you alluded to the fact that he had to come before Congress because of allegations and questions about things that he was pushing, that, you know, diet drugs and programs that weren't necessarily what he was selling them as. You know, those are going to be absolutely part of the political conversation. Everything, you know, when you're a celebrity, obviously you have name ID, which is huge in politics. That's the plus. The downside is when you're a celebrity, you have name ID and therefore, and you have a history that has nothing to do with politics, and therefore you have a giant target.
Talk to us about Dr. Oz and his chances, where he stands among Republicans right now.
Yeah, I mean, look, here's the deal. If you look at the polling before Dr. Oz got in the race, look at this. Last month, 78% of Pennsylvania registered Republicans were undecided in who to vote for in the next primary. So this is a field that is wide open for Dr. Oz to get into.
All right. What are the betting markets? You know, first of all, I should note, one of the reasons it's so wide open is Sean Parnell, who
Correct.
Was seen as the leading candidate, more or less dropped out
Correct.
Because of legal issues he'd been having. But what do the betting markets say?
Yeah, so the betting markets, which is essentially a view of conventional wisdom, right? So this is basically your chances of winning per the betting markets. Look at that. He's already up at 36%. He's ahead of the rest of the field. And part of that is because unless you're really into Pennsylvania politics, you probably haven't heard of these other three that are going on here. Because as you mentioned, Sean Parnell left the race. He was endorsed, I believe, by President Trump or former President Trump. He was sucking up all the oxygen in the room. All of a sudden, he gets out. It leaves the room wide open for somebody who can build name ID very, very quick in that state.
Now, in terms of the Republican primary, obviously, Donald Trump will be a major factor.
Donald Trump will be a huge factor. And the reason Donald Trump will be a huge factor is because Donald Trump, just like with Republicans nationally in the state of Pennsylvania, he is beloved. Look at that, a 75% favorable rating in an average of the last two Franklin and Marshall polls. So this just gives you an idea that if you get in the race in Pennsylvania, right, and you're a Republican, you can't annoy this guy, because if you do, Pennsylvania Republicans will turn against you.
Trump had endorsed Sean Parnell, who dropped from the race. One of the questions is, will Trump get behind anyone here? Mehmet Oz, a fellow entertainer. Who knows? Oz has been speaking glowingly about Trump the last few days. Let's talk about the general election.
Yeah.
If Oz were able to win the Republican nomination, then what?
Look, President Joe Biden, his numbers in Pennsylvania, just like they have nationally, have dipped. You can see this very well. You know, if you look back at October of 2020, his favorable rating in the state of Pennsylvania was 52%. You look in October of 2021, it's 45%. That tends to be a pretty good recipe for Republicans to make gains nationally, and it's also probably going to be the case in Pennsylvania. And if you don't mind, I'm going to jump ahead a slide. You may have a question, but I'm going to jump ahead just because I think it works so well as a transition. When a president's approval rating is below 50% in Pennsylvania, look at these Senate races in Pennsylvania in midterm since 1994. The president's party has lost all four, 94, 06, 10, 18. And obviously, Dr. Oz is not in the president's party. He is running in the opposition party. The opposition party has won all four of those races. So Republican on the ballot, if President Joe Biden is unpopular in Pennsylvania a year from now, as he is today, that would leave the door wide open for a Republican to win.
We have a lot of history in Pennsylvania, these competitive Senate races, where you can learn from something like this. All right, what do we know about celebrity politicians in general?
I mean, look, they can be fairly successful, right? You know, obviously we think of former President Trump as a successful politician insofar as he won the presidency, but he's not the only one. You know, you go back in 2008, Al Franken won in Minnesota. You go back to 2003 in California, Arnold Schwarzenegger won. 98, Minnesota, Jesse Ventura. 94, Tennessee, Fred Thompson winning a Senate race. Of course, Ronald Reagan, who was probably the original celebrity who won the presidency, started off winning the California gubernatorial race in 1966. So the idea that as a celebrity you can't win in politics and that Donald Trump was somehow unique doesn't hold. There are plenty of celebrities who have made that jump from being a celebrity or an entertainer to winning political office, major statewide political office. Will Dr. Oz be one of those? We don't know. But it's certainly, there is a roadmap here. It has worked before.
I will say, most of these people were involved in the political world in some way between their entertainment role, much more so than Dr. Oz, but we'll see.
Well, I mean, look, we will see, but this is a unique time in our politics. And as I pointed out earlier on, you know, when you essentially have 78% of the field that's undecided, that's something you can really jump into and get name recognition, spend a lot of money very quickly, which Dr. Oz is planning on doing. He has a real shot here.